Okay, in this video, we're going to talk about some very common and well-used properties for math, and they're used in basic mathematics as well as algebra, and they don't go away, so you need to get to know them, and we'll be using them as we solve equations in an upcoming video. The commutative property, you know, commutative, I think, comes from the word commute, and commute means to go to and from someplace. Example, in the morning, you go from home to school, and then you reverse it or flip it and go from school back to home, commute from one place to another. So to show you an example of the commutative property for addition, it would simply be something like this. If I have 4 plus 3 is 7, then the commutative property says that I can also add 3 plus 4 is 7 and get the very same answer. The order doesn't matter in addition, and when you switch places, that's the commutative property of addition. So the commutative property for multiplication would be the same. If I have 3 times 4 is equal to 12, then 4 times 3 is also equal to 12. So commutative simply means switching places. Okay, now let's go for the associative property. The associative property, associate means to group. So I'm going to show you how to group numbers. Let's say I have a 6 plus a 4 plus a 2. Now, it might be that one person knows that 6 plus 4 is a 10 combo, and they may want to add those two first. So I'm going to put parentheses around just so you'll know what the thinking process is. And they'll do 10 plus 2 is 12. Someone else may see that 4 plus 2 is 6, and double 6, 6 plus 6 is 12. Either way, it doesn't matter how we group the numbers, we're still going to get the same answer. So this is the associative property for addition. The numbers are in the exact same order, but the way I group them is different. That's what makes it the associative property. So the associative property for multiplication would look just the same. If I have 4 times 2 times 3, and down here I have the very same numbers in the exact same order, then perhaps this person might want to group it 4 times 2 is 8, and then 8 times 3 is 24. Whereas someone else might like or know their multiplication better this way. 2 times 3 is 6, and 6 times 4 is 24. So those are examples of the multiplication property for the associative property for multiplication. Okay? Now I'm going to try to fool you. I'm going to put something up here, and I want you to decide if it is the commutative property or if it's the associative property. Okay, here we go. Let me erase these just a minute so I'll have room. Okay. I'm going to make an addition statement, and you tell me if it's commutative or if it is associative. Okay, I'm going to go 4 plus 3 plus 5, 3 plus 4. Plus 5. Okay, let's take a look. I do have parentheses, but does parentheses always mean associative property? Have I grouped them? Yes, I have. Has the grouping changed at all? Or did I just switch the numbers? Well, let's take a look. When we did the associative property, we said that the numbers stay in the same order and the grouping parentheses changes. In this problem, I switched 4 plus 3 and 3 plus 4, and the parentheses remain the same. So because I switched the numbers, though it may look like associative property, this is an example of the commutative property for addition. Don't be fooled by that, okay? Now let's go for what we refer to as the identity properties. There is one for addition and one for multiplication. The identity property for addition simply says this. If I have a number, what can I add to that number to keep it the very same number? Well, that makes sense. If I have the number 4 and I don't want it to change, then let's add what to it? 0. So 4 plus 0 is 4. The identity for addition is 0. And for multiplication, what do you think the identity would be for multiplication? If the identity for addition is 0, what would the identity for multiplication be? Let's use the same 4. Let's go 4 times what will keep us at 4? You know what it is. 4 times 1. 4 times 1 is the identity property for multiplication. 1 is the identity for multiplication. For addition, 0. For multiplication, 1. But there's also a multiplication property of 0. I know it sounds kind of silly because everyone should know, or hopefully knows, that any number times 0, except when you get in a hurry, and when you get in a hurry, sometimes you say 4, any number times 0 is 0. So we have the identity property for addition, which is 0. We have the identity property for multiplication, which is 1. And then we have the multiplication property of 0, which says any number times 0 is 0. And the last thing we want to talk about will be the multiplicative inverse, commonly known as the reciprocal. And we did that when we were dividing fractions in the past. The multiplicative inverse for 3/4 would be the flip, the reciprocal, which would be 4/3. The multiplicative inverse for a negative 2/3 will be a negative 3/2. The multiplicative inverse for 3, now keep in mind that there is a 1 underneath that 3 because every whole number has a 1 underneath it. So I'll just do that to make it a little easier for you. The multiplicative inverse for 3 is what? Flip it. Is a 1/3. And on negative 4, you know there's a 1 underneath there. So the flip or the reciprocal will be a negative 1/4. Okay? Now, here's the interesting thing about the multiplicative inverse. When you multiply a fraction by its inverse, watch what happens. Regardless of whether it is a positive or negative. Remember when I did inverse, if it was positive, I kept it positive, and if it was negative, I kept it negative. Now, watch what will happen, because this is going to really become important as we do equations coming up real soon. If I multiply 3/4 by its reciprocal, and you can play cross-sets if you like, but for now, let's just look at it. 3 times 4 is 12. 4 times 3 is 12. 12/12. Is equal to 1. Every time you multiply a fraction by its reciprocal, you will get a positive 1 answer. A negative 2/3 times a negative 3/2, well, in multiplication, a negative times a negative is a positive. So we have 6/6, and 6/6 is equal to 1. On this one, we have 3, or 3/1, times 1/3, and that is 3/3, which is equal to 1. And then on the bottom, we have a negative 4 times a negative 1/4. 2 negatives make a positive. That will be a 4/4, which equals 1. And they're all positive.